Today's video will be about how the first television set was invented, when did the broadcast service begin, when did the remote control appear, and how the television evolved since its invention. Television is a way of sending and receiving moving images and sounds over wires or through the air by electrical impulses. The word television first appeared in 1907 in the discussion of a theoretical device that transported images across telegraph or telephone wires. Ironically, this prediction was behind the times, as some of the first experiments into television used radio waves from the beginning. The big breakthrough in technology was the ability to send sound and pictures over the air. The word television comes from the Greek prefix tele and the Latin word vision, or seeing from a distance. On the 25th of March 1925, John Logie Baird, a Scottish inventor, gave the first public demonstration of television in London, using a mechanical system. At this stage, it consisted only of moving silhouettes. By the following year, Baird has improved his system enough to reproduce a recognizable human face, that of his partner Oliver Hutchinson. It used only 30 lines to produce the image. In 1926, Kenjiro Takayanagi demonstrated the first TV system that employed a cathode ray tube display at Hamamatsu Industrial High School in Japan. This was the first working example of a fully electronic television receiver. The first commercially made electronic televisions with cathode ray tubes were manufactured by Telefunken in Germany in 1934, followed by other makers in France and Britain in 1936 and USA in 1938. The cheapest model with a 30 cm screen was $445, equivalent to $8,567 in 2021. On the 2nd of November 1936, the BBC began the world's first high-definition television broadcast service. Back then, high definition was classed as a minimum of 240 horizontal lines, rather than the 1080 horizontal lines of today's digital high-definition television. It was, however, very much high definition when compared to earlier systems, which were only 30 lines. On April 30, 1939, the National Broadcast Company, NBC, broadcasted the opening of New York's World's Fair, including a speech from Franklin D. Roosevelt. By this point, NBC has a regular broadcast of 2 hours every afternoon and was watched by approximately 19,000 people around New York City. Television usage in the Western world skyrocketed after World War II. While only 0.5% of US households had the television in 1946, 55.7% had one in 1954 and 90% by 1962. In the 1950s, the electronic television sets were still large and bulky, with analog circuits made of vacuum tubes. After the invention of the first working transistor in 1947, Sony developed the first fully transistored portable solid-state television set in 1959. On June 25, 1951, CBS broadcast the very first commercial color TV program. Unfortunately, it nearly went unwatched since most people had only black and white televisions. Despite these early successes with color programming, the adoption of color television was a slow one. It wasn't until the 1960s that the public began buying color TVs, and only in the 1970s, the American public finally started purchasing more color TV sets than black and white ones. The first remote intended to control a television was developed by Zenith Radio Corporation in 1950. The remote, called Lazy Bones, was connected to a television by a wire. In 1956, Robert Adler developed Zenith Space Command, a wireless remote. It was mechanical and used ultrasound to change the channel and volume. In 1974, appeared CFAX, world's first teletext service by BBC. It offered a range of text-based information, typically including news, weather, and TV schedules. In the mid-70s, the videocassette recorders became sufficiently inexpensive to be purchased by millions of families for use in the home. The industry boomed in the 1980s as more and more customers bought VCRs. By 1982, 10% of households in the United Kingdom owned a VCR. The figure reached 30% in 1985, and by the end of the decade, well over half of British homes owned a VCR. In 1980, a Canadian company, Viewstar, developed the first TV remote to use infrared technology, a low-frequency light beam invisible to the human eye and capable of operating various electronic products. In 1982, Seiko Epson released the first LCD television, the Epson TV Watch, a small wrist-worn active matrix LCD television. The TV Watch was equipped with what was at the time the world's smallest and lightest television. In 1995, Fujitsu has developed the world's first 42-inch widescreen color plasma display. Philips introduced the first large commercially available flat panel TV in 1997, with a cost of $15,000, including in-home installation. By the year 2000, prices had dropped to $10,000. On the 23rd of July 1996, WRAL HD becomes the first US television station to broadcast a high-definition signal. This milestone, witnessed by a mere handful of invited guests, was the culmination of a 20-year global initiative to improve the over-the-air TV signal that hadn't changed in four decades. The last day of analog TV broadcasting in USA was June 12, 2009. In late 2006, analysts noted that LCDs had overtaken plasmas, and in 2007, LCD televisions surpassed sales of CRT-based televisions globally for the first time. In 2007 appeared the first smart TV, with integrated internet and interactive Web 2.0 features, which allows users to stream music and videos, browse the internet, and view photos. It's unclear who invented the very first smart TV, because there were many different companies and inventors experimenting with the technology at the time. The world's first organic light-emitting diode, OLED television, was designed by Sony in 2007 and produced for sale the following year. It was also the world's thinnest television during its production at 3 mm, and its cost was $2,500 for an 11-inch screen. Although the first 4K display was invented in 2001, only in late 2012 the first TVs with 4K resolution were released by LG and Sony. The list price was $20,000 for the LG and $25,000 for the Sony. In 2019, LG launched the first rollable TV for a price of $87,000. This TV offers three diverse viewing formats called Full View, Line View, and Zero View. Full View is the standard TV mode, Line View is for displaying other media like photos, playing music, or showing the time, while Zero View means the OLED panel is fully enclosed in its aluminum case.